For today's history video, I'd like to go back to the War of 1812. It's a war that was over before it began and which was fought after it ended because of the time lag in communicating between London and the United States by sail ship, not even steamship. The basic cause of the war were the orders in council that were adopted by the British cabinet to cut off American trade with France so that an embargo of the French and of the occupied territories on the continent could remain and they could be cut off from imports from the New World. And to maintain that embargo, the British fired on and took over any number of American ships, seizing them because they contained cargo that was destined for France. Well, the United States kept hounding Britain to repeal those orders in council and demanding that they did. And then Thomas Jefferson said, okay, we're going to ban all trade with Britain and France, by the way. We're not going to export to anybody. And it'll hurt us, but it'll hurt you more. In fact, he was wrong. It hurt us much more than it hurt them. But Jefferson maintained that policy, and when Adams became president, in 1809, he continued the embargo. And the embargo began really to hurt the British merchants and the British public. So the cabinet met and repealed the orders in council, eliminating the cause for the embargo and preventing the War of 1812. But as that was being voted on in London, the United States Congress was declaring war on Britain, and the messages crossed in the mail. And it was 2 months before the United States learned that Britain had basically conceded and the war was unnecessary, 2 months into America's war preparations. And we had expanded the army, expanded the navy, the country was in a war fever, and it just couldn't be reversed. So it was a war that ended before it began. Then, at the other end of the war, the United States initially did very badly in the war. Washington was occupied and Capitol and the White House were both burned to the ground by British troops, and our efforts to conquer Canada failed miserably. But at the end of the war, we scored a huge success when Andrew Jackson led the American army in defeating the British army in the Battle of New Orleans, with huge casualties on the British side and negligible casualties on the American side, even though the Duke of Wellington's brother-in-law, Parkham, led the British forces and was an army of veterans of the Napoleonic Wars. But the problem is that that battle took place 2 months after the Treaty of Ghent, which was signed in Ghent in Belgium, ending the War of 1812. So this was a war that ended 2 months before its last battle, and which began 2 months after the cause for starting it ended. Thanks for watching.